watching the undefeated Anthony Joshua.
We meet up on the Wednesday, always. We go to D&L Barbers, which is in Holloway. And then from there, depending on where the location is, we make our journey. And then hotels on Wednesday, just really relaxed, just chilled out.
Wednesday's a beautiful day because you've been working for so long and you know that judgment day is upon you. But at the same time, the main thing you're thinking about is, thank God I've got 2 days rest.
It's good, I've been training long and hard. When it comes to a stage in the camp where you're like, quite there, when it's quiet and we're here now, so I'm happy, I feel great.
You've got your supporters there, you've got people who have come to see you lose, everyone's roaring. So you're going to flex, show your supporters you look good, show your enemies that I'm here, I'm not messing around. So this is your time to show people, look, 10 weeks of hard work, you know, I'm chiseled, I feel great, and I'm going to put it on tomorrow.
When we're together and everyone is closed door, all busting joke, and we're going through Instagram and laughing and stuff like that.
It's like a bachelor's pad because I've got all my boys, all my family. My boys are like my family anyway. So they pass through, we make sure we bring the PlayStation. You know, you just want to have fun, enjoy people's energy, take it all in, recharge yourself.
Quiet day tomorrow. Just had a good time with my family and friends, had good food, played a bit of PlayStation, Destiny, FIFA. Always good to have your people around to take your mind off the job at hand. I'm mentally in a good place and physically because I've been living properly and training hard, so everything's come together.
We'll just make sure everything's ready. For example, like anything other than fighting, he shouldn't really have to worry about on the fight day.
What's his all about?
Always good, my man. Always good. How are you? Okay, yeah?
He's very into what he wears. He doesn't have a stylist or anything, so when it comes to the fight gear, he's got a lot of the input.
Wow.
Those are serious. Yeah, I like to be involved for sure. I'm the one wearing them at the end of the day, so I've got to be happy.
That is serious.
That's very Gladiator Hercules.
It's like genuine Napa butter with a red salt on it.
I do like the old school, but at the same time, I do like a bit of flash as well.
Serious. Are we taking those to the arena?
We've got a minivan, so there's always going to be like, you know, 5 or 6 guys in there. I'm trying to chill out and get in the zone. Then I might have an old school friend who's still having jokes and laughing with me. I'm looking at him like, bro, I'm about to go and fight. Get out of the van, the cameras are there. It's time to get to work and show these people why you're the next heavyweight champion. Until I step into that ring, I don't feel nervous.
I wouldn't even know he's fighting, it's just no change in behaviour to how I see him in the week.
How are you, mate? You good?
Not bad.
Jesus, I'm about to massage.
Mate, why are you so chilled out?
I'm all about stand now. I'm here, so just enjoy it.
He looks as cool as anything now, just waiting to go out and perform, and that's a pretty good state of mind to be in.
I'm not going to get my guns out, I promise. Sweet man,
got a world champion.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Cheers, boy.
He's massive. Just when I said goodbye to him, then I put my arm on his shoulder and I was like, oh my gosh, that's only his back muscle. That's 7 times my bicep.
Getting my hands wrapped is like a spiritual thing, you know. You get signed off by the British Boxing Board of Control. You look at your hands, you feel good. You're getting ready for war. Even though it's the hurt business and the fight game, we do have rules and regulations and it is a discipline.
Imagine you listen, right? A lot of shouting in the box,
Stop boxing, break, and don't hold.
In the back of your head, you're thinking, but it's a fight, you're pumped already. But you respect the rules, you respect the regulations.
How old are you? 26.
I'm 26?
Yeah, I'm trying to knock years off. I'm 26, so.
You're putting a lot on the line on fighting that, so the doctor's just making sure that he's giving you the best opportunity to let him know if you're injured or there's anything wrong with you before you go out to battle. I've done my pads, I've done my skipping, I've stretched off. Coach has slapped me on the back of the head, I'm pumped, you know. My team are thinking, please win, you know, I want a job tomorrow. So there's a lot of pressure. I'm walking out now. I feel good, that's what I do. The nerves kick in for me when I step in the ring.
It's all about Anthony Joshua and how he performs. The smile, as always. Loves what he does.
The last bell goes, and may the best man win.
Joshua looking very sharp. Joshua knows him with a left hand wide in trouble already. The right hand raised him. Joshua being right up across. It's all over in 90 seconds. Joshua going to watch again, and there's it. It's over. Done. And sights all out. Dramatic and unbelievable at the finish.
We'll have a little chat about
alright. After the win, we go back in the changing room, everyone comes in. Closest friends, family. And there's so much energy inside the changing room.
If it's a routine fight, I'm cool. But when it's a fight that I put everything on the line, we've gone to war, the adrenaline is phenomenal, it's fantastic.
How am I going to stop these body shots? Smash!
Coming back with your friends and family, everyone's pumped, everyone's had a great night, everyone wants to be on the winning side, and that's for the majority of my career going to be my side. Never forget where you came from. Keep your feet on the ground, but still reach for the stars. When you require a little bit of success, you gotta keep your feet on the ground and keep on going. Stay humble.
We were born and raised in Watford. Life was cushy. Watford is a really small residential town. So, everyone knew everyone.
Auntie was actually quieter with your sister. His sister was more, even more boisterous, and she kind of took charge.
He excelled in sport, so we're not surprised that he's ended up, you know, where he is in his career. He was doing really well in football, but I think he found his thing with boxing. I live just down the road. And mum and Anthony are in Golders Green as well.
Yeah, still is a reason, mum. Yeah, stay humble.
Reason I'm still at home is because I don't know any different. I feel that all I need is my bed, my family are happy. While I'm doing what I'm doing and fighting, I'm not at home much. I'm at training camp a lot of the time, away from home. And when the time's right, I'll make the decision to move on from here. Mum worries about me because she sees how I come home on the weekends from training. You know, I'm injured, I'm battered, I'm tired, so imagine what she'll see me like on fight night.
She doesn't watch fights. She hates to see her son in the ring, so she'll message me and be like, Skins, how's the fight going? How's Anthony? I don't blame her for it. It's her son. Anything can happen in the ring. I don't think she would want to see anything bad to happen.
I wouldn't want her to come because to see her son fighting for a living, I would think she would rather me use my brains, but I'm good with my fists.
It's stopped, it's over.
And she's happy with the man that's made me today. So she does look away from the brutality of it and she does see the man that I've become through boxing. So that's where she supports it.
Joshua asked a lot of questions tonight. Came up with the answer when it mattered.
You're only as good as the company you keep. And the company I keep are very motivated people and they keep me in check as well as I keep them in check.
I've basically put the wrong tickets in someone's envelope and so I've now got to go all the way to the arena to swap the tickets around. It's all good though. Get to stretch my legs. I know AJ's for about a good 6-7 years now. Years ago, when he used to play football, we all just kind of met each other from there. And from there, one of my close mates, James, he started coming to loads of my events that I ran, brought Anthony along, and then kind of just connected from there.
Known Anthony since I was about 16, just from being around Watford and always bumping into him. A few years later, he moved down to where I live, and we both played football, same group of friends, just gelled.
Even though we're friends, we've got a real good working relationship.
On the boxing side, I manage the ticket sales for the local area. Anyone who needs them outside the internet comes to me.
That's not me!
These have been up, bro. That's why over 2,000 tickets have been sold through our chat.
I'm just there for my friend, you know what I mean? Anything he needs us to do, just give us a call. If we can do it, we'll do it.
Because he's my best mate, I'm always going to believe in him and faith in him. But put friendship aside, look at him as a man, how he carries himself.
He doesn't shy away from anyone. He's always got time for everyone. So if you want a picture, you'll get a picture.
You're meeting the fans who've come to support you anyway. So you're open to their wishes, their pictures, their autographs. It's no problem.
And the thing is, he remembers. He genuinely does remember. He just stays humble.
That just shows a part of someone that's very nice, genuine, and care about people.
Nah, that's Tony. I left mine in the car.
If there are people out there that are inspired by him, it's all about his humility and his attitude. And I think that gets you so far in life. We all knew that Mum was having issues with her old car. He was like, don't tell Mum, but we've got somebody coming to deliver a brand new white Range Rover to the house with a bunch of flowers for her.
Safety first.
She couldn't believe it. And you can imagine how it feels to be able to make your mum feel like that. So we were proud of him for that.
It'd be great to be heavyweight champion of the world, but I'm happy with the man I've become and the man I'm developing into.
That's what I'm saying.
Do you lie in bed now thinking, I'm going to be the heavyweight champion of the world.
Yeah. I think I'm still going to be in the same flat.
Life is training.
Always training.
Weekdays he's training several times a day, whether it's boxing, whether it's cardio, whether it's weight training.
Every day, 6 o'clock, running. If he's not in the gym, he's running on the road.
My life maybe would have been successful, hopefully, within bricklaying or music or something I had another passion for. Boxing was individual. No one could guide me, no one could tell. This was me and that gym. I knew what I was going into, I knew the pain I was putting myself through. There was times that I didn't want to go back. There was times that people didn't believe in me. And I just kept on breaking through these boundaries, breaking through these barriers. And through that, it built the man I am today.
I enjoy it. Nothing really I don't enjoy.
Strength conditioning is always tough. There's always different phases. Power, speed, aerobic work. It always covers my whole body, like your core, your glutes and your legs and so on. And I like to work those areas because that's really my foundation. I've got a window of opportunity to make the most of what I'm doing. I'm still young, I can sleep 3 hours and get up and train a full day with no problem. But when I'm 30 years old, 40 years old, I won't be able to do those same things. So I'd rather put the work in now rather than trying to do it in the future where my body's not the same as it is when I'm youthful. I've got to look deep within myself and ask myself how much I want it. What am I here for? Don't lose that desire.
What we're doing today is evolving the boxing brain, really, because I need to outsmart my opponents, because I'm marking out strength for them. I'm fitter than them. I'm taking up Spanish just to stimulate my mind and use my time wisely when I'm not training my body physically. Nine-week hardcore training, we're in week 2 now. And what is it? It's going to be 8 Saturdays and I'm in the ring fighting, so it's not long.
This fight has sort of been unprecedented in terms of scale. Before the British title fight, you know, interest really peaked and thought, wow, this is really happening now, but this has been a different league.
Sparring is real tough. To replicate a fight, we spar 12 rounds. I'd have about maybe 3 different sparring partners. Spar 4 rounds, fast, competitive. He gets out, fresh one comes in, tries to take my head off. And I just got to hold my own throughout this sparring session. And my coach is never happy, but I've got to do my best. Some sparring partners want to test themselves and see where they're at, because one day they'll potentially be fighting me. I've had some good scraps, but they're character building, you know. And no one wants to get punched in the face, but part of my job, and just got to keep on going. I feel like the hard work early on was done. Now it's just staying consistent throughout camp. We're going to finish off sparring, obviously the road running and conditioning, and just maintaining and staying injury free. We go intense and then we taper right down towards the fight. So fight time, we've restored our energy and then we pick up again for fight time.
He handles his business very well.
Pleasure, absolute pleasure.
The appetite for Anthony Joshua is absolutely massive.
You know what she's saying, yeah.
He won't just put a signature to anything, and he really looks into things and he asks a lot of questions. He took a long time to go from the GB camp to going professional, for a whole year. He looks into things, his best options, what's right for him in the near future, not what's best for him now.
The Olympics gave him that platform, really, but he's built on it so much to the point where, you know, we're getting some seriously heavy-hitting brands that are now working brands, and they want to be a part of sort of brand Joshua.
See, we're in good company with Matt Bradley as well. Yeah. And Ali and Mike Tyson, so
The Rock.
He's transcending boxing. What he's continuing to do in the ring, how he handles himself outside of the ring, is building a bigger audience.
These are the shorts I fought in to compete for the British title. You know, so these shorts and this guy have a lot of meaning. This is a jacket as well. Something different. Old school fighters years ago were more in like robes and dressing gowns. This is a new era now. We're designing body warmer type jackets to come out in with hoods and looking cool, stylish. Nice to work alongside with the kit designers to make something that you're comfortable in and add some sort of sparkle and some fashion elements to it.
You know, he's hopefully about to become the heavyweight champion of the world, so we want as many eyeballs in that fight as possible, really.
I think for my next fight, I might go all white. You know, white boots, white thing. That was like Ali. And he used to come out, so I'm going to try that.
Since capturing Olympic gold, he has a perfect professional record. 14 fights, 14 victories.
Could Anthony sell at Wembley Stadium? Absolutely, he could. He could have for this fight. I think he could have for the last fight. I think it's only a matter of time.
There's never a warm-up like it before you go out and fight. You know, this is the last time you're going to punch a pad before you go out in front of thousands of people. You do definitely need to get the blood flowing. You're getting yourself pumped up as well psychologically. You're just brushing up on your skills, and that's why we spend so long warming up, just trying to get the shots right. The relaxation is important. And just having that connection between athlete and coach and making sure you're on the same wave, you understand your instructions and you know what you've got to go and do. Now it's time to get real serious. It's important to maintain a good balance throughout training camp. Stretched while I'm relaxed, so everything's in place. So when it comes to April 9th, I'm the guy that I've been training to be for the last 10 weeks.
Everybody on their feet here.
Every fight you step into the ring could be your last fight, whether it's a journeyman or a world-class champion.
He's in the bowels of the arena.
It's just been a whirlwind journey.
Five of his victories have come in the first round, seven in the second round.
It's just growing so quickly for Anthony.
The blistering start to his professional career.
Getting in the ring, there's nowhere to run.
Anthony Joshua is beginning to make his war.
First started boxing in 2008, learning my trade for a good 6 months. 2010, was building, fighting. 11, I was at the World Championships, Baku, a year before the Olympics, competing for Great Britain, and I managed to secure myself an Olympic qualifier and a silver medal in a real tough fight.
Watching loads and loads of YouTube videos on Ali or this boxer or that boxer, and we all are like, he's found his true passion.
Do I love boxing? Of course I do. It's become my life. It gave me opportunity and it gave me, most importantly, vision. A few months later in London, you know, I haven't been boxing for long, it's a bit crazy. But I managed to stand myself on the number one podium at the Olympics, and I turned my silver medal at Baku into a gold.
All I can remember about the Olympics was going like this.
This is a real nice piece of art. Underneath here, it's engraved boxing men super heavyweight, 91 plus kilograms. This is something that I may put in a museum one day when I'm older so it can inspire many people.
I was at the finals at the Olympic Stadium with my mum. The second fight in his whole boxing history that she's actually been there to watch, because she can't really watch it, she doesn't enjoy watching it. We cried, we screamed, we shouted.
What I'd done in 2012 has spurred me on. At the time, it didn't mean so much to me. It was like, I put it behind me, let's crack on. But now I realise the importance it's done preparing me for these trials and tribulations I'm going to face moving forward.
Two undefeated fighters and somebody's O has got to go.
I'm ready to get the job done tomorrow. God willing, it goes my way, I become British champion and I can move on to world title honors. One step at a time now, and my vision is fully focused on getting this win. The day of the weigh-in was in the van, Stormzy came on, and at the time that he just released the song, and I thought, you know, this sounds good, but not really a ring track. The boys are telling me, nah, trust me, this is the one, this is the one.
He's excited about the whole thing. He's there, like, Snapchatting, like, but as you can see, like, means a lot to him, which is nice as well.
He's blowing up on social media, like, well, I ain't got no followers like Kim Kardashian or nothing like that, but in my little world, he's done well. Message him on Friday, come down Saturday morning, one or two rehearsals, went home, shower, come back in the evening and performed in front of a sold out O2 Arena.
This is nothing that man's done. Like, nothing.
In your composure, it just seems like you just come here and just take it over. Yeah.
In close, in punches up, in close what you had to, know what we had to do.
Me and Dylan have got history from 2009, and what I realised is that when me and him come together, it's just a pub fight. He wants to fight me, I'm not backing down from no one. Tough fight, first round I thought I had him.
Joshua, right hand, left hook, and Dillian White is in desperate trouble. And still Joshua now smiles at his man. Last few seconds of the opening round, and Joshua continues after the bell. Same turn as Dillian White.
Second round before he had me.
And now it's Joshua, without the pressure. Joshua in big trouble.
We both got back to boxing, and I managed to become victorious. Kind of about self, that fight, self-resilience, pride, fighting spirit, how much you really want to dig deep when times get tough. I fought Dylan's fight and still beat him. It's not always going to be the yellow brick road, it's going to be tough, and you just have to dig deep and find that character within yourself.
But every time I was hitting him, I was thinking, for goodness sake, it's hurting him, but it's not enough to knock him out. You know? But even in the first round, I had enough power to hurt him, but I was loading up too much. And that's learning, that's why you need the rounds.
This is the British belt, some real history in this belt, some great people have won this belt and gone on to do great things. And hopefully, I can keep on adding to my collection. So these belts here, as a professional, are leading me to the heavyweight championship of the world.
You know, we got a lot of fans over here, you know. I plan on coming over here and making them my fans. You know, the prince has landed.
Charles Martin, current IBF heavyweight champion of the world. I think he's had 24 fights, 21 knockouts. Someone who believes in himself, someone after defeat, and take what he's bringing to the UK from me.
I thought it was a bit premature. tough. Pressure's on now. But it's a massive opportunity. He can turn down.
It's a step up, but you see how he's training, you see how much he dedicates to it, and you see how committed he is to it.
I took away the fact he's champion and looked at him as an opponent, just strictly as an opponent, and I believed I can beat him. And he actually came forward to challenge me.
We're quite easy to negotiate with, and we've got the deal, and we're ready to rock and roll for the night. And I'm really happy that we can bring back a heavyweight champion fight back to Great Britain after so many years.
I think they could have sold out the O2, which is the biggest arena in the country, probably three times over. I mean, they sold out in 90 seconds.
His goal has always been to unify the division, so however that comes about, whoever's got the belts, they'll be the targeted fight.
In a year from now, we could be staring down the barrel of a huge unification fight, hopefully, you know, with a Tyson Fury or a Deontay Wilder, possibly Wembley Stadium, which again, we'll start to get into completely uncharted territory, I think, in terms of British boxing.
The world is his oyster. The only person that can beat Anthony Joshua is Anthony Joshua.
There's no stopping AJ. He's a train just going straight.